Hello students, now I am going to discuss another experiment which is determination of rigidity modulus by dynamic method. Now what is the definition of rigidity modulus? So you know that within elastic limit the shearing stress by shearing strain is the rigidity modulus. Now here this is the schematic diagram of the setup. So this is one setup where you can see this is called the cradle. Okay, now in cradle these are some load. So you can see here this is the instrument. So this there are some load are kept. So why this load are kept? So if you place it in such a way it becomes in a equilibrium position. Okay, and here you can see there are three wheels. Now what is the use of these three wheels? So you can see here this part, now this part is touching this beam. Now by revolving these three wheels you can keep this, you can keep this, see it is coming like this, like this middle position. So it is now in a position where this cradle is not touching this beam. Now we are ready to do the experiment. So before discussing the experiment, let me give you some theoretical background of this. So the time period of oscillation of this cradle. Now if I twist this, if I twist this cradle, it, you can see it is oscillating. So the time period is basically T0 equal to 2 pi root over I naught by C. What is I naught? I naught is the moment of inertia of this cradle. Now this is a very uneven structure, we can't measure the moment of inertia of this cradle. Now what we will do, we will use one reference body, that is this known body. This known body is a cylindrical body. So now you can place, you have to place this cylindrical body on this cradle. Okay, so you can place it like this or you can place it like this. And you have to again do the same thing. Okay, so you have to find out the time period of this torsional oscillation. So what is this oscillation? This is something different from your simple harmonic oscillation. This is different. This is torsional oscillation. Here, when you are doing this, your wire is twisting. Okay, so that's why the formula is 2 pi root over I by C, not 2 pi root over L by G. So that you have to remember. Now when we are placing this cylindrical body, the time period becomes like this, because this is I naught, that is the moment of inertia of the cradle, and I1 is the moment of inertia of this cylinder. Now I told you, you can place the cylinder in that way or like this. So that I have shown here. So this is the axis of rotation, this is the axis of rotation. So you can place it like this or you can place it like this. Now when you place it like this, in place of I1, you have to put the mr square by 2. When you place it like this, you have to put like this. Okay? Now, so when you are twisting your wire, so there will be a torque is generated. So when you are twisting the wire, there will be a torque is generated, and that is proportional to the theta. Theta is the shearing strain. And this proportionality constant C is called torsional constant, and the value is this in this case. So this can be proved, we are not going into those proof. And you can see this is depend on eta, eta is called the rigidity modulus. So here this eta we have to find out. What is R? R is the radius of this wire. What is L? L is the length of this wire, so we can measure the length from here to here by the meter scale. And if you put this C and if you use this time period formula, so this eta will be like this. So this is our working formula, where L is the length of the wire, I1 is the moment of inertia. So any one of these two you can use. So accordingly you have to place your body. This R is the radius of the wire, this is the time period when you are putting the body on the cradle, and this is the M time period when there is no body, means empty cradle. Okay? And So we have to measure the moment of inertia here. So that's why we have to measure the mass of the known body. So in that case we will give you, so you have to measure the mass of the this known body in that case. So there is one spring balance. So we will give you one measuring kit by which you can measure the mass of this body. You have to measure the length of this known body, that is this. You have to measure the radius of this known body, and you have to find out the moment of inertia. Okay, so this is the basic underlying theory of the rigidity modulus measure by dynamic method. Now, why it is called dynamic method? So this is one important question of Weber Bose. So this is called dynamic method because here time is involved in the equation, and this is very accurate measurement with respect to another experiment, that is measurement of rigidity modulus by static method. So here we are measuring the time, that's why it is called the dynamic method. So first of all, we will measure the radius of the wire. So this is the screw gauge, and you have to place the screw gauge like this, and in different places, in suppose three places you have to put, and suppose for this place, so you can see the reading. So here the main scale reading is 0, and the vernier scale, the circular scale reading is 76. So the total reading will be the 0 plus 76 into least count. Now what, how can you measure the least count? The screw pitch by the total number of divisions. So here screw pitch is I can see 1 millimeter, and the total number of divisions here is 100. So 1 by 100, that will give you the least count. Okay, so you can measure the R by this way. Now length, so by meter strip you can measure this length, and for I1 already I have told how to measure. You have to measure the mass by this spring balance, you have to measure the length of this cylinder, you have to measure the radius of this cylinder. Now time period for this, so for T, measurement of T0, so this is the empty cradle and it will oscillate like this, and by stopwatch for suppose 30 oscillation, you have to find out the time, and you have to divide by divide the time by this 30 number. It will give you the time period. Okay, then you have to put this cylinder like this, and again you have to oscillate it, and you have to measure the time for 30 oscillation. Okay, so full oscillation you have to measure. Now, so how, what is the full oscillation? If I start suppose from here, so when this part is again going here, it will give you one oscillation. So be careful when you are doing this oscillation. So after measuring all those parameters, put the all those parameters here in the formula, and it will give you the data. Okay, thank you.